Several open source budget documents indicate the U.S. Navy is in the process of developing lasers for its Virginia-class attack submarines. Some of these documents, which date back to 2011, show that the U.S. Navy wanted laser weapons fitted to the Virginia-class submarines so that the submarines can take out potential targets swiftly. This plan by U.S. Navy will be one of the most audacious moves if implemented. Some reports indicate that the laser is already being tested. Prima facie, it looks pointless since lasers don't work underwater, but laser weapons attached to the mast will be able to attack targets that are above the sea level. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the deployment of laser weapons in Virginia-class submarines of the U.S. Navy. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support, so grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The Virginia class, sometimes referred to as SSN 774 class, is a class of nuclear-powered fast attack submarines in service with the United States Navy. Virginia class is designed to replace older Los Angeles class submarines, many of which have already been decommissioned. The Virginia class was intended in part as a less expensive alternative to the Seawolf class submarines, whose production run was stopped after just 3 boats had been completed. These submarines of the Virginia class are designed for a broad spectrum of open ocean and littoral missions. Their primary purpose is to take out enemy surface combatants and submarines, and the second task is to execute land attack missions. Submarines of this class have a length of 115 meters. To give viewers a perspective, the length is slightly greater than that of a football field. These submarines displace around 7,900 tons and are acknowledged to be able to move to depths of 240 meters, that's about 800 feet, but allegedly capable of going down to 490 meters, or 1,600 feet. A single S9G reactor that produces around 30 megawatts powers Virginia-class submarines. The S9G reactor is designed to operate for 33 years without refueling. This enables the submarines of this class to have a practically unlimited range, limited by only food supplies and maintenance requirements. The reactor produces enough power to propel the submarines to over 25 knots. That's 46 kilometers per hour, or 29 miles per hour, though the actual numbers may be significantly higher. The Virginia class ushered in many technological advances in submarine construction. It's the first to use photonic sensors instead of traditional periscope. The class is equipped with high-resolution cameras, along with light intensification and infrared sensors, as well as an infrared laser rangefinder. Starting Block 4, the submarines incorporate a large aperture bow, lab, water-backed array, which replaces the traditional air-backed spherical array. This main sonar is one of the most powerful sonars mounted in any of the submarines in the world. The Virginia class is built through an industrial arrangement designed to maintain both General Dynamics Electric Boat and Huntington Ingalls Newport News, the only 2 U.S. shipyards capable of building nuclear-powered submarines. The facilities alternate work on the reactor plant, as well as the final assembly, test, outfit, and delivery. Virginia class has a plethora of weapons. 1. There are vertical tubes to carry Tomahawk submarine-launched cruise missile, SLBM, unmanned undersea vehicles, UUV. These could also potentially carry non-nuclear medium-range ballistic missiles. 2. 4 533mm torpedo tubes for the Mark 48 torpedo. There's a capacity to carry up to 26 Mark 48 torpedoes in the weapons chamber. These torpedoes have a range in excess of 50 kilometers or 31 miles and can be used to take out enemy submarines and surface vehicles. 3. The boats are able to lay different types of mines, including the Mark 60 Captor encapsulated torpedo mines. 4. An integral lockout lock-in chamber is incorporated into the hull for special operations. The chamber can host a mini submarine, such as Northrop Grumman's Advanced SEALs Delivery System, that can be used to transport special warfare forces, such as Navy SEAL teams. Documents indicate that the high-energy laser, HEL, would be of around 300 kilowatts. This would eventually end up to be more powerful, up to 500 kilowatts. It will be powered by the S9G reactor. As per some reports, the initial prototype has already been tested using a towed power generator instead. Though the U.S. Navy has been tight-lipped regarding this, a laser could have several use cases. The laser can be used as a last-ditch defense against drones and anti-submarine helicopters. The current crop of American submarines, like most others, doesn't have any defense against air attack, as they spend very little time on the surface. This is especially true for U.S. Navy subs, as they're nuclear-powered and don't need access to atmospheric oxygen for propulsion, unlike diesel-electric subs, which do so by surfacing or using a snorkel. Modern subs generally depend on their undersea cover to avoid attack from the air. There are exceptions, for example. Interactive Defense and Attack System for Submarines, IDAS, is a submarine-launched, lightweight, multi-role, fiber-optic guided missile system being developed for the German and other partner navies to take out aerial threats. A system like IDAS is useful when the cover of a submarine is blown. Viewers may note that modern anti-submarine aircraft and helicopters have many ways to detect submarines. Laser weapons have some distinct advantages over a system like IDAS or guns. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, as traditional systems can run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats, like a drone swarm. Also, a platform firing laser will be much harder to detect than one firing a missile, since lasers are invisible and there's no blast associated with it when fired. The laser could also be used to take out small missile-firing boats, the likes of which are possessed by North Korea and Iran. Expending torpedoes that are limited in numbers is not the most effective solution in these scenarios. Laser weapons could also potentially be used to strike high-value tactical coastal targets, such as radar stations. U.S. President Donald Trump revealed on the 19th of July 2019 that the USS Boxer downed an Iranian drone. As per him, the drone came within 1,000 yards of the U.S. Navy ship and ignored multiple calls to stand down. Mr. Trump, speaking at the White House, has said that the drone was threatening the safety of the ship and the ship's crew in the Strait of Hormuz and was immediately destroyed. In December of last year, the U.S. Navy has confirmed that multiple small Iranian boats ran alongside the Nimitz-class aircraft carrier USS Abraham Lincoln and other ships from her strike group as she sailed through. These incidents exhibit the emerging threats and new challenges of modern warfare. U.S. Navy already has 17 Virginia-class attack submarines. Last year, the U.S. Navy awarded its largest ever shipbuilding contract to General Dynamics Electric Boat. The contract, worth $22.2 billion, will see the construction of 9 Block 5 Virginia-class attack submarines. So, the fleet is getting expanded. In the coming days, if these submarines get laser weapons, it will add a lot of flexibility to the U.S. Navy. Virginia-class submarines are considered one of the best attack subs, and the inclusion of laser will give them a unique capability.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and
kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.